Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, I have this 12 volt power supply. It is 12 volt 10 ampere. What is the problem in this power supply? I have 235 volt input, but the output, that is 5.4 volt, but it is fluctuating. The output is not stable. If we try to adjust it, it just only moves some millivolt from minimum to maximum. The main problem, it has fluctuation. How to troubleshoot? Let's start. We have to remove this screw. I remove this screw. Now I will remove this screw for the cover, and now we have to slide it to left side, this side. So it have two latches here on this cover. It is removed now. It have 110 volt and 220 volt option input circuit. It have two capacitors and it have two MOSFETs. It is using KA7500 IC. So that means it is a push-pull topology. In the visual inspection, if we check this capacitor, it has swelling. It's this surface is raised up. This is plain, but it has swelling. So that means this capacitor have over temperature. It is in visual inspection. So we have to check this one. Might be it is damaged. I have to remove this screw for the rectifier heatsink. And we have to open this MOSFET heatsink from here. Now I am removing this screw for the chassis. Now the PCB is free. Never touch the PCB before discharging the capacitor. To verify for more safety, we have to check the voltage on the DC rail. DC voltage, it has 0 volt. This capacitor has 0 volt. So we have to remove this capacitor and we have to check it. Now we remove this capacitor and we will test it. First of all, we have to discharge it. Then we have to check the capacitance. So this capacitor is not good. It is giving 650 nanofarad. So its value must be 100 microfarad, 450 volt. And we will check this capacitor as well. So both capacitors are not good. It is giving 100 nanofarad. Comparatively, if we check this capacitor, it is 47 nanofarad, 47 microfarad. So it is giving some good reading. But these capacitors are giving just only 80 nanofarad. So that is not a good reading. So we have to replace these capacitors. 78 nanofarad, that is not acceptable. Now I have two capacitors. The one is 100 microfarad, 400 volt. The second one, 400 volt, 180 microfarad. So we will use these capacitors as a test purpose. First of all, we will test it. So So it is giving 95 microfarad. That is good. And we will check this one. It is also 180 microfarad. It is showing 170 microfarad. So it is 180 microfarad, 170, that's good. But our these capacitors, the original capacitors for the power supply, were giving just only in nanofarad. So these capacitors were bad. Now I have two capacitors. One of them is 100 microfarad, 400 volt. The second one is 180 microfarad, 400 volt. So I will use these capacitors as a test purpose. We cannot use these capacitors for a permanent solution as its size is long. So it will not fix in the body. So we have to purchase the original capacitors, original size capacitors. Now, how to install capacitors? To install capacitor, we have to take care for the polarity. We have to locate the bridge. Bridge rectifier, cut side. This is the cut side. So cut side is positive. So we will install first capacitor here. The positive side on this line. Positive side on this line. So it is, its positive end will reach to the bridge rectifier. The second end of the bridge rectifier, that's here. It is going through NTC, negative temperature coefficient resistance. It is NTC 5D11. So after passing through NTC, it will reach here. So here we will connect the negative end of this capacitor. So we will connect the negative end of this capacitor here. Now we connected these both capacitors. These capacitors are just for test purpose. Now I will connect power. It's power on. Let's check output. Negative, positive. Wonderful. We have 15 volt now. That's good. We will adjust the output. Now we have regulated 5 volt. Before this, it was 5 point some voltage, 5.4 volt, and it was fluctuating. Now we don't have fluctuation. It is now stable voltage. The problem in this circuit was that these both capacitors were damaged. These were not providing the required current on DC rail. So the complete load of the MOSFET of the power supply on the bridge rectifier, and between bridge and our required circuit there is NTC, so it was stopping the current, it was limiting the current. So that was the reason that the voltage on DC rail were down. So it was not fulfilling the requirement of the power supply, so it was causing the dropped voltage and fluctuation in the output. So we need a regulated voltage, a ripple free voltage, and a backup voltage on the DC rail that can fulfill the requirement of this power transformer and the MOSFETs. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please let me know in the comment box. I will share the design details in upcoming video, how this circuit is working. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please let me know in the comment box. I will share the design details in upcoming video, how this circuit is working. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.